My next guest is the father of a sixth grader who was inside the school when the shooting started. He penned a Twitter thread that begins, "There was a shooting at my son's school today," where in real time he writes about the visceral, gut-wrenching process of learning that there has been a shooting at his child's school. Steve Holley and his son Nate join me now from Highlands Ranch. So thank you two so much for being with me, and I can't even begin to imagine what this is like for you. And Steve, just I have to start with you, because just being honest, I had reservations about you bringing your, you know, your 12-year-old son on a day after the shooting, and I just want you to tell me why you felt so strongly about him being on national TV. What do you want us to know about your son?
I mean, I honestly didn't feel strongly about him being here. I really completely left it up to him. I asked him this morning, and I just approached him and said, "Hey, buddy, I you know, heard from CNN, and they asked if I might want to be on TV to talk about what happened at your school. Is that something you might want to be a part of?" And he's like, "Oh, I'll kind of think about it." So honestly, he didn't really decide to come up until just about, you know, literally when we pulled in the parking lot. But I do feel it's important to not only hear from the adults from this, but also maybe more importantly, to hear from the kids.
All right, so Nate, how are you doing?
I'm doing okay. It was incredibly scary during it, and at least half the kids in my class broke into tears when it started happening. It was incredibly scary, and our teacher had us hide in the closet.
Oh. Can you, I would have been so scared, and can I just say you are so brave to be standing there with me today, and I am in awe of you. Can you take me back to yesterday and tell me what happened?
So, I have sensitive ears. So, they shot out the doors, and I heard the gunshots, and I just kind of froze. And then the siren came on, and our teacher, and somebody started cracking a joke, and the teacher told them to shut up, and then she had us hide behind her desk. And when the shooter got closer, she moved us into the closet. I was hiding in the corner, and they were right outside the door. I had my hand on the metal baseball bat, just in case, because I was going to go down fighting if I was going to go down.
Then you were going to go down fighting with a baseball bat. Nate, yeah. And again, how old are you?
I'm 12.
Steve?
Yeah.
I just wanted, can I talk to your dad just for a second? I mean, this is your child. Yeah, thank you. I will. Steve, I mean, I'm sorry, forgive me. It's just to hear your precious child describing holding a baseball bat and hearing gunshots in the window. Mm-hmm. How do you process that?
I don't think you can process that. I think, you know, this community out here in Colorado, we've been through so much recently. You know, as I mentioned in one of my the first tweet that I sent out was, this is the third time I've had to pick up my kids from a lockdown at their school due to a school shooting or the threat of a school shooting. We don't live in this district we choiced in, but we do live in the Littleton School District, which is where the Arapahoe High School shooting was a few years ago. And a dear friend of ours lives across the street from us, and she was a teacher there. And we have another dear friend of ours who lives in the neighborhood. So it feels like this just, for whatever reason, continues to happen out here. And enough is enough. We need to make a change, and we need to do something, or else we're just going to continue failing our kids. The fact that my 12-year-old has to tell you that, and everyone else, that, you know, the situation that he went through. I certainly couldn't have done it when I was his age, and my wife and I've been on the verge of tears since, so we're just still trying to process this.
When you're processing it, when you're sitting there at the gym, which became what's known as the Family Reunification Center, right? And so that's where all the parents go,
yes.
And that's where you're waiting for information on your son, and you are there yesterday for five hours. And so many parents you know, can't even begin to comprehend what that must feel like, hearing names called out, wanting to know if your child is alive, and the not knowing. Mm-hmm. Can you try to put that into words for me?
Yeah, I mean, I hate to use the word lucky. We were blessed in the situation that from the moment I heard something was going on until the moment I heard from Nate was quite literally seconds. My other son goes to school in a different school district, and our carpool called and said, "Hey, do you want me to pick up your other son because of what's going on at STEM?" And I thought, sure, free ride. Why not? And yeah, that'd be great. Thank you. And then I went on to Twitter, saw what was happening, and almost immediately my phone rang, and Nate had borrowed a friend's cell to give me a call and let me know what was going on. And I just told him to be brave and told him that I loved him and told him that his mom and I were on our way. When we arrived at the center, it actually wasn't chaotic. We walked in with another father who I believe had heard from one of his children but not from the other, so he was worried. And then his wife actually pulled in, so he ran to be with her. When we got into the gym, just, you know, there are over 1,800 students here, so just imagine the parents of 1,800 students in this small gym all wondering what's going on, meeting each other for the first time or for the, you know, having been lifelong friends. And so we were just all kind of trying to gather as much information as we could. So most of us, all of us, were on our phones just trying to figure out what's going on in social media and trying to parse out what was fact from what didn't sound to be true.
Of course. And I want to go back to your little man. Nate, I want to end with you. I got a couple more questions for you, okay?
Yeah.
My gosh, I'm in love with your child. Two questions. One, do you feel like, did you practice for yesterday? Did you feel like what you would practice for was kicking in?
Can you recite the question? Sorry, it's pretty loud out here.
Absolutely. So did you run drills? Do you know what a code red drill, or were you prepared for what happened yesterday? Did you know what to do?
No, it was really chaotic. This has never happened to me before, and I was really unsure. We had a drill like once or twice this year, but I didn't know, most of the kids didn't know what to do.
And last question, what do you want everyone watching to know about you?
That's a hard question.
I don't mean to stump you.
Can I just have to think about that?
You can think about it and you can get back to me. I'm gonna go ahead and say you are brave and everyone knows it.
Thank you.
Nate, thank you. Nate and Steve, what a moment. Thank you guys both so much. I am so glad you are A-okay. And just a reminder to everyone watching, this was the 35th school shooting since the fall. This is a crisis. You heard that, child.